This is old age female presented with history of insidious onset, chest pain, and dyspnea. This is with the contrast.
Okay.
هنيدة، ممكن تكبرين شوية السكشن سوي له ماجنيفيكيشن بالعدسة فوق بعد هنا اكو ماجنيفيكيشن تتكبر هاي
اي عمو بس هاي ما اعرف شلون تدخل هذا ال
بس دوسي السهم اللي جوا واختار ال
قاعد تشتغلين من اللابتوب لو من ايباد؟
اي عمو من اللابتوب بس
عندك
هاي
ماوس؟
ما
عندك ماوس؟
لا عمو ما عندي ماوس.
هي من الماوس تقدرين كنترول بهاي النوب اللي هاي بالنص صعديها تكبر.
اي عافية. يلا هسه اوضح يمكن دكتورة وداد.
نعم استاذ.
ارجع اعيدها لو اكمل.
كورونا الأذن دكتورة. نعم أستاذ. multiple CT scan section with contrast showing mediastinal phase ما يعني pulmonary central pulmonary mass with collapse of upper lobe multiple mediastinal lymph node. بس دكتورة نرجع على الأجزية شوي هاي الصورة بعيدة ممكن شوي. This is MS. Causing bronchial collapse and distal bronchial collapse and distal lung collapse. They must show contrast enhancement. بس دكتورة تبقي رجعي للماس يعني okay, this is mass show contrast enhancement causing compression of adjacent main bronchus also multiple lymph node يعني شفت pleural thickening اكو وفيوجن pleural thickening and effusion patient ايش قد عمره دكتورة؟
old age female, 72 سنة عمرها.
ماشي.
Then we are dealing with pulmonary
with
mass.
Pulmonary mass. نعم استاذ. Contrast enhancing pulmonary mass.
Lymph nodes, aku consolidation.
Consolidation. Collapse consolidation.
يعني شو تخليه يبالغ؟
يعني نخلي bronchogenic firstly start, bronchogenic carcinoma.
Bronchogenic.
ممكن lymphoma مهم نخلي differential diagnosis بس يعني first انه bronchogenic carcinoma اخليها start.
بل.
طيب هسه هاي lung window, scan lung window also show collapsing. Of lung.
Is it badly Joe?
No.
كم تايب عندنا اذا كانت برونكيال مثل ما قلتي؟
يعني استاذ برونكوجينيك كارسينوما عندنا السنترال تايب اللي هن ممكن سمول سيل لان كانسر عندنا السكويمس سيل كارسينوما عندنا الادينو كارسينوما يصير اكثر شيء بيرفرال وعندنا اندفرنشيتد هنا اندفرنشيتد تايب هو الماست كمان هو الادينو كارسينوما
الادينو
الماست كمان بس السنترال اكثر شيء السمول سيل لان كانسر يجي سنترال وليف نود ويعني يكون متستسز ات تايم اوف دايجنوسيس
ويا اللي ويا سموكينج اكثر
هو السمول سمول تايم
سمول سيل
سمول سيل ويا سموكينج اكثر
طبعا اذا تلاحظين حتى الليفت مين بالمنري ارتري ناروينك صاير بي وهذه
ناروينك نعم
استاذ اوكي نروح الدكتور هدير شكرا وداد دكتور هدير
السلام عليكم
عليكم السلام your opinion بابا بدنا نسمع شيء هدير السلام your opinion بابا
صوتي شو ماس With pleural thickening, multiple pleural thickening nodule, irregular. Extend to the mediastinum with compression of the compression impact on the left pulmonary artery associated with mild pleural effusion on the left side. The mass is irregular, all defined border, infiltrative through the mediastinum. The ribs seems normal, no destruction.
شفت بالبريس اكو شيء؟ ارجع على البريس الليفت بريس اكو نبر ريتراكشن
اكو لايك ما صار تكون برونكوجينيك كارسينوما سنترال برونكوجينيك كارسينوما
يعني هسه الماس هذه اللي ات ذا بايفركيشن اوف ذا تراكيا لو البرونكاي اور
نعم استاذ العفو
الماس
نعم
سنترال او بيريفرال
العفو استاذ هسه اللي جاي اشوفها هي سنترال بير هايلر اكستند تو ذا ميدياستاينوم
بل والفولفنج ذا بلورا ومسويه بلورال ديبوزيت كانما وياها فيوجن وهذا
بلي 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 مالتيبل
واكو شيء اخر همينا ريدكشن بالفوليوم اوف ذا ليفت لانج اوفر اول من بالضبط اي اذا انت تقول هذا سنترال تايب واكو بلورال ديبوزيت او ميتاستسايز لها شفت شيء البريست
والله يا دكتور شو اسوي لنا سكان على البريست نزلي اكو نبل تراك لا ماكو شيء صار هاي النبل موجود
شكرا هدير
الله يحفظك
نروح نرجع على هنيده تحكي لنا على الكيس تحكي لنا على السريع واذا مسويه توك حتى نستغل الوقت ابني لانه تاخرنا
So this is a 72 years old female presented with the history of the gradually increasing chest pain and dyspnea, was recently diagnosed as a small cell lung cancer, biopsy proven, and referred to the oncology teaching hospital for the investigations done, including the CT scan of chest and abdomen with IV contrast. This show left hilar enhanced lobulated left hilar soft tissue mass encasing the left main pulmonary artery and the left main bronchus and involving even the superior pulmonary vein with the evidence of the pleural involvement in form of the multiple confluent heterogeneously enhancing variable size nodules involving most of the pleural surface, including the mediastinal pleura, and even involving the outer surface of the pericardium. There is also a left-sided, small left-sided pleural effusion with the multiple, this is the pleural effusion, with the multiple large mediastinal lymph node, including the subthyroidal lymph node and the contralateral mediastinum. There is also a ipsilateral left lung volume loss. And on the lung window, as we see it, we saw it, there is an incidental finding of the paraseptal emphysematous changes and the subpleural retraction. So the rest of the exam is unremarkable. So such a case would be classified as an extensive disease according to the International Association for Study of Lung Cancer. And she has been scheduled for the palliative chemotherapy. I'll go to the talk, sir.
Hey, Bratich, pardon.
طبعا موضوع اللون كانسر بتشعبات هواية، اختصار للوقت راح اتكلم فقط عن سمول سيل لون كانسر. Or as it is called an odd cell lung cancer, which is a subtype of the bronchogenic carcinoma that is distinct from its partner non-small cell lung cancer because it has its unique presentation, imaging features, treatment, and prognosis. So small cell lung cancer considered one of the neuroendocrine tumors of the lung that cause paraneoplastic syndrome. It grows rapidly, highly malignant, widely metastasized, and despite of showing an initial response to the chemotherapy and radiotherapy, actually it has a poor prognosis with only 5% the 5-year survival rate, and usually it is unresectable. It represents about 15 to 20% of the lung cancers and is strongly associated with the cigarette smoking. Its clinical presentation is usually variable, may involve just a constitutional symptom in form of the weight loss or malaise, effect of the primary tumor in form of the calf dyspnea or local invasion with the compression of the adjacent structures like esophagus causing dysphagia or the recurrent laryngeal nerve causing hoarseness on the airway causing citrida. And usually it is the most common tumor to cause a superior vena cava obstruction that will result in the facial or the upper body or the upper arm flushing and swelling. Also rib erosion, metastatic spread, which is present about 70% of the cases at the time of the presentation in form of the bone metastasis that would cause hypercalcemia and bone pain, or the CNS involvement in form of the cerebellar degeneration of limbic encephalitis, also liver metastasis that would cause right upper quadrant pain. And it is the most common type of the lung cancer that would cause paraneoplastic syndrome because of its production of the variable hormones, including the ACTH causing Cushing syndrome, syndrome of the inappropriate ADH secretion, parathyroid hormone causing the hypercalcemia, hyperparathyroidism. Also, it has been implicated in the pathology of what is called Lambert-Eaton syndrome, which is an autoimmune disease that attacks the neuromuscular junction, causing weakness of the proximal part of the body. About 90 to 95% of the cases occur in the central location, so it lies adjacent to the lobar or main bronchus. Also, those patients may have elevated level of the lactate dehydrogenase, and this is usually not a specific marker, but have been shown that those patients who have an elevated level of the lactate dehydrogenase, they have overall poor survival rate. About the radiographic features, actually on the plain radiograph, does not have any specific features, may present as a hilar or perihilar mass, but the most striking feature will be the mediastinal widening because of the mediastinal lymph node enlargement, even if the primary mass is not obvious. On the CT, on the CT, the same mediastinal involvement that could be similar to the lymphoma can show the direct infiltration of the adjacent structures or the superior vena cava obstruction. Usually, small cell lung cancer characterized as a mass lesion where necrosis and the hemorrhage are both common. Only rarely, it will present as a solitary pulmonary nodule. This is a case of the extensive mediastinal involvement as we see it with the superior vena cava obstruction. About the staging, previously small cell lung cancer was not staged in the same manner as non-small cell lung cancer. But since 2013, the International Association for Study of Lung Cancer have used to stage it in the form of the limited disease and extensive disease, where we have the limited disease will be confined to the single hemithorax, single radiation port, and ipsilateral mediastinal or supraclavicular lymph node. Those patients can be offered a chemo radiotherapy. While extensive disease is not confined to a single radiation port, can have contralateral mediastinal or supraclavicular lymph node involvement, malignant pleural or pericardial effusion, and metastatic disease, and this compromises about 70% of the cases and can be offered only a chemotherapy. As we said, most of the cases will present in the advanced stages. Only 5% of the cases present in the early stage, that is stage 1 or 2A, with potentially curable disease. Those patients could be managed with the aggressive chemotherapy or even lobectomy with the mediastinal lymph node dissection. But beyond these stages, surgical excision is not recommended, and any nodal involvement will not benefit from the excisional treatment. Brain metastasis will be present in about 1/4 of the cases at the time of the presentation, and is a known site of the disease recurrence after the initial response. Prophylactic cerebral irradiation can be offered for those with adequate systemic control and without central nervous system metastasis. About the differential diagnosis could include other types of the lung cancer, especially the squamous cell carcinoma that could present as a central mass, also lymphoma because of the mediastinal lymph node involvement, others like the pulmonary sarcoma or pulmonary metastasis. And these are the references, and thank you.